I am Santosh Gangar. Today I am teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I am focusing towards the Hartnell governor problems. The Hartnell type of spring loaded governor rotate about the vertical axis. The two rotation masses are 1 kg. The data is given. M is equal to 1 kg and moves at a radius of 0.12 meter when the speed is 550 rpm. Okay, if the arm is 100 mm, A and B is here, the length is respectively vertical and horizontal. When the equilibrium speed is, when it is 574, then it will be N. If it is N, this will be R. Therefore, R is equal to 0.12 meter and N is equal to 550 rpm. And A is nothing but 100 mm, A is nothing but 0.1 meter. And B is nothing but 75 mm, 0.075 meter. Equilibrium speed N2, they are given it. N2 is nothing but 575 rpm. The rotating mass and the maximum radius R2 is given, 145 mm. A is nothing but in terms of meter, 0.145 meter. Determine the stiffness. Stiffness is nothing but K we have to find out. And at which the maximum mass rotate when the equilibrium speed is, the N1 is also given. N1 is nothing but 525 rpm. And the radius at which the mass rotate when the equilibrium speed is, we have to find out R1 here. The R1 we have to find out. Everything they are given here. Okay, first you have to find out the stiffness. What is the stiffness formula? Okay, first I will draw the diagram here. This is the diagram. This is F. This will be W plus S divided by 2. This is A, this is B. Next will be here in this way. This is F2. The diameter, radius they have given it R. We have to find out this one. Sorry, R they are given it as R1. R is nothing but 0.12 meter and R2 0.145 meter. One more diagram will appear here. Here the distance R1 we have to question mark. This is we have to find out. This will be W divided plus S2 divided by 2. Here W plus S1 divided by 2. This is the diagram. Now what we have to find? We have to find out the stiffness. Stiffness we have to find out. But we don't know R1 here. Then we will go for comparison between equilibrium speed and maximum. Then you can find out the stiffness. Okay. Stiffness formula will be K is equal to. This is the stiffness formula between equilibrium and the. It will be 2AB whole square into F2 minus F divided by R2 minus R1. Not R1, only R. Only R. R. We are finding this difference between these two. Because the R1 is unknown here. We have to find out. At the final stage, we have to find out R1. Now I will find out the stiffness. First, I will find out F. F is nothing but M omega square R1, where M is equal to 2 pi N divided by 60 whole square R1. M is nothing but 1 into 2 pi, N is nothing but 550 divided by 60 whole square. R1 is nothing but R. In case of normal, you have to take M omega square into R. R will be 0.12. Answer will be, for this one, the answer will be 398.07 Newton. Next, I will find out F2. F2 is equal to M omega square R2. Now it is R2. M 2 pi N2 divided by 60 whole square R2. Now 1 into 2 pi into R2 n2 is nothing but 575 divided by 60 whole square into r2. R2 is nothing but 0.145. The answer for this one is 525.72 Newton. Next, after getting this one, substituting this formula, k is equal to 2, a is nothing but 0.1 divided by 0.075 whole square, 525.72 minus 9398.07 divided by r2 is nothing but 0.145 minus 0.12. The answer for this one is 18154.67 Newton meter. After getting this one, we have to find out what? We have to find out, determine the stiffness of the spring and compression at this one. Okay, the compression is also we have to find out. The compression we have to find, determine the stiffness of the spring and compression at 550. 550 is nothing but we have to find out initial compression, that is this one. Compression. That's yes, we have to find out, that is at 550 rpm, that means at average, at equilibrium speed. What is the formula for this one, finding this one? This is the formula. S is equal to 2 AB F minus MG. MG, whether they are given the MG? No. Make it 0. 2 into 2. S is equal to 2. A is nothing but 0.1 divided by 0.075 into F1. F1 is 398.07. S1 will be 1061.52 Newton. We got the compression also, initial compression we got it at 550 rpm. The radius at which we have to find out, the radius at which the mass rotate at 525 rpm. Now we are finding the radius when speed is 2525 rpm. R1 we have to find out. How to find out this one? What is F1? F1 is nothing but M omega square 1 R1. What is M? 1 into 2 pi N1 divided by 60 whole square R1. 1 into 2 pi, this is N1, this will be N1, into 525 divided by 60 whole square R1. If you multiply, it will be 3022.56 R1. Next, we have to find out the R1 value. How to find out the R1 value? There is a formula. You have to use this one formula for finding the R1 value at any instinct. At any instinct. The formula will be F is equal to F1 plus F2 minus F1 R minus R1 divided by R2 minus R. What is F? F is already known. F already known. 398.07 is equal to F1 will be 3022.56 R1 plus F2 will be 525.72 minus 3022.56 R1 into what is R? R is nothing but R is 0.0.12 minus R1 0.145 divided by R2. R2 is no R1 no sorry R1 should be unknown. R1 is unknown here. R1 divided by R2, R2 will be 0.145 minus R1. R1 will be 0.12. Now, how to find out R here? By using the calculator, 398.07 alpha is equal to 3022.56 alpha x plus 525.7.72 minus 0.22.56 alpha x. In place of R1, you have to place alpha x into bracket 0.12 minus alpha x divided by 0.145 minus 0.12, close the bracket, shift solve is equal to the answer will be 0.11. Everything is fine here. 52. Okay. Oh, sorry. Sorry. This is also R1. Now I have to place in place of this one X value. Alpha X. I have to place. Now shift solve is equal to. Now answer for R1 is, R1 will be 0.103 meter. I have replaced here. This should be R1 should be as it is. Then you will obtain the answer directly by using the calculator. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.